Hello everyone, welcome back to Law on Obligations and Contracts. And for this video, we will discuss the four kinds of defective contracts. So the first one is rescissible contracts. So rescissible contracts are valid until rescinded. There is a sort of extrinsic defect consisting of an economic damage or lesion. So actually, rescissible contract is a valid contract. Kaya lang, meron lang defect or economic damage or lesion, kaya siya naging defective contract. Second, voidable contract, valid until annulled. The defect here is with respect to the consent, no? Third one is unenforceable contract. The contract cannot be sued upon or enforced unless ratified. It doesn't have any effect until ratified. Fourth one is void, one that has no effect at all. It cannot be ratified or validated. So as you can see, the first three kinds of defective contracts are from the beginning valid. But later on, because of the defect, because the injured party learned of the defect, pwedeng it's either nirescind niya yung contract or nag-annul siya ng contract or hindi niya in-enforce yung contract, learning of the defects. But the fourth one, itong void na contract, hindi talaga yan valid from the very beginning. And we will learn later ano yung mga contracts which are not valid from the beginning. Okay? So, let's go first to rescissible contracts. So, under Article 1380, contracts validly agreed upon may be rescinded in the cases established by law. So, what is rescission? It is a relief to protect one of the parties or third person from all injury and damages which the contract may cause to protect some preferential right. Okay? So, relief daw itong rescission. So what are the requisites? Number one, there must be at the beginning either a valid or a voidable contract. So at least voidable yung contract, no? Or valid talaga yung contract. Second, the contract must be rescissible as provided by law. So malalaman natin later kung paano ba magiging rescissible yung contract. Third, the party asking rescission must have no other legal means to obtain reparation. Walang ibang remedy kundi mag-rescission. Fourth, the party asking rescission can return whatever he may be obliged to restore. Kasi in rescission, parang you will, ano kasi yan, parang ang ibig sabihin kasi ng rescission, restore. You will restore everything, no? From the beginning to the beginning. Ibalik mo yung kung ano yung beginning, yung hindi pa ka nag-contract. So therefore, kung may nabayad na sa'yo yung other party, you should return it. Kasi restoration ang meaning ng rescission. So if you are asking for rescission, you must be capacitated to return whatever you may be obliged to restore. Fifth, the object of the contract must not be in the legal possession of a third person acting in good faith. Why? Because sabi nga natin, di ba, in rescission, meron tayong tinatawag na restoration. It means that you will return what you have received, di ba, in rescission. And therefore, if the object of the contract is now in the legal possession of a third person, how can you restore or restore what you have received? So it would be impossible. Kaya naging requisite siya for rescission. Sixth one, the action for rescission is brought within the prescriptive period of 4 years. So meaning to say, hindi forever, walang forever sa action for rescission. So meron tayong prescriptive period na 4 years. So kung nalaman mo na meron palang defect yung contract nyo, you should file an action as early as possible from the time you discovered it. Or from the time, oh yun nga, from the time you discovered the defect. So that it can be remedied, no, within the prescriptive period. Otherwise, you will lose that right of action. Okay, let's go to Article 1381. So, ano yung mga contracts which are rescissible? First, those which are entered into by guardians whenever the wards whom they represent suffer lesion by more than 1/4 of the value of the things which are the object thereof. So let's make this instance or this this circumstance easy, you know, for you by giving you an example. Let us say, for example, the guardian, sino itong guardian? Usually, kapag merong minor and the minor has properties of his own, sabihin natin, the minor is an actress. So, meron siyang pera. And ngayon, merong guardian, di ba? So, the legal guardian normally is the parents now. So, the parents now will enter into a contract of sale. For example, binenta nila yung lupa na pagmamayari ng minor. Let us say yung value ng lupa is 1 million pesos. Pero binenta lang nila, kasi 1 million, magkano yung 0.25? Binenta nila for 500,000 only, yung value, yung lupa na pagmamayari ng minor nila na anak. So, a question nito is whether or not valid ba yung contract, okay? So, assuming of course that there is an approval no of the court. Merong approval ng court yung pag-sell nila sa property. Pero kaya lang nangyari is 500,000 lang yung price na sa pagbenta nila. Pero yung value ng lupa is 1 million. Ngayon, anong sabi ng first paragraph? Those which are entered into by guardians, whenever the wards whom they represent suffer lesion by more than 1/4 of the value of the things which are the object of thereof. So magkano yung 1/4 ng 1 million? So compute it, the result will be 250,000. Next question, magkano yung price ng pagbenta ng parent, ng legal guardian? 500,000, di ba? So meaning to say, there is an economic damage. Nagkaroon ng lesion of more than 1/4 of the value of the thing. Ang value ng thing, 1 million. Pero yung selling price, 500,000. Meaning to say, half yung nawala sa minor. So, kung ganyan ang mangyayari, ang status ng contract is rescissible. Question, ma'am, valid ba yung contract? Yes, valid. Balikan natin yung basic, no? Sabi dito, di ba? Rescissible contracts are valid until rescinded. Okay? So, kailan mo, anong gagawin mo ngayon? Kasi merong economic damage. So, you will file a case in court to rescind that contract. So, the minor will file a case in court para iparescind niya yung contract on the ground of lesion or economic damage of more than 1/4 of the value of the thing. Second, those agreed upon in representation of absentees if the latter suffered the lesion stated in the preceding number. So, same is true with absentees. Sino itong mga absentees? Yung mga person na hindi mo na alam kung nasa na sila? Yung whereabouts nila is unknown? Tapos nag-iwan sila ng administrator ng properties nila, pati yung administrator hindi alam kung nasan yung kanyang amo. So, ang tawag sa amo niya is absentee kasi wala siya sa place at hindi, walang nakakalam kung nasan siya. So, what if for example, yung kanyang administrator binenta niya yung lupa na pagmamayari ni absentee, tsaka yung value nun is nag-suffer ng lesion of more than 1/4. Anong dapat gawin ng absentee? Same sa paragraph 1, pwede niyang iparescind yung kontrata because of economic damage. And take note, the economic damage must be more than 1/4 of the value of the thing. Okay? Third, those undertaken in fraud of creditors when the latter cannot in any other manner collect the claims due them. So ito, fraud ito. Anong example nito? Kunyari, ikaw, isa kang creditor. Ngayon may nagkautang sa'yo. Yung katabi mo ngayon. Baka wala kang katabi, di ba? Kasi mag-isa ka lang, nakikinig ng video natin. Okay? So, para hindi ka makakolect sa kanya, okay? Binenta niya lahat ng properties niya. Okay? Binenta niya lahat ng properties niya para wala kang mahabol sa kanya at makapag-declare siya na bankrupt siya. Wala siyang perang pambayad sa iyo. So ngayon, nalaman mo ngayon, na-discover mo ngayon na niloko ka lang pala niya. Ibig sabihin, ang purpose ng pagbenta niya pala ng lahat ng properties niya is para hindi mo makolekta yung utang niya sa iyo. So meaning to say, the contracts of sale of all his properties are undertaken in fraud to defraud you so that he cannot pay you. So in that case, ano ang remedy mo ngayon? You can file an action for the rescission of the contracts entered into by the debtor defrauding you, okay? So pwede mo yung pwede mong i-rescind 'yon. Hanapin mo yung mga kontrata, yung mga alienation of properties, no, to third persons para yun iparescind mo 'yon sa court. So yan yung remedy mo. Those which refer to things under litigation, if they have been entered into by the defendant without the knowledge and approval of the litigants or of competent judicial authority. O ito. Kunyari yung property, subject siya ng case or litigation. Tapos ngayon, itong defendant, binenta niya. Eh wala namang authority from the court kasi you cannot sell a property subject of the litigation. Okay, you cannot enter into contracts with respect to that property, no? Without the knowledge and approval of the litigants or of competent judicial authority. Bawal yun. Kailangan humingi ka muna ng consent sa court or sa kabilang party na, kunyari, i-mortgage mo yung lupa or i-collateral mo. Pwede sana yun kung merong knowledge at consent nila. Kaya lang, kapag hindi ka nag-secure ng knowledge and consent, meron silang right to rescind the contract, okay? Fifth one, all other contracts specially declared by law to be subject to rescission. Ayan. So under Article 1383, the action for rescission is subsidiary. It cannot be instituted except when the party suffering damage has no other legal means to obtain reparation for the same. So this is one of the requisites before you can file an action for rescission. Di ba sabi natin, kailangan walang ibang remedy kundi rescission na lang talaga. Kaya nga sabi dyan, subsidiary, pangalawa lang. Kasi kung meron kang other legal means to obtain reparation for any damage, then you should resort to that legal means, no, before ka mag-resort into action for rescission. And punta tayo dito sa Article 1385. Rescission creates the obligation to return the things which were the object of the contract together with their fruits and the price with its interest. Consequently, it can be carried out only when he who demands rescission can return whatever he may be obliged to restore. Diba sabi na kanina, dapat yung person na nag-demand ng rescission must have the capacity to return whatever he may be obliged to restore. Kasi kapag sinasabing rescission, balik yan eh. I-return mo yan kung ano yung object sa contract. Kung pera ang nabigay sa'yo, uwi mo yung pera. Kung car, edi uwi mo yung car, etc. Neither shall rescission take place when the things which are the object of the contract are legally in the possession of third persons who did not act in bad faith. Yan sinabi natin kanina. In this case, indemnity for damages may be demanded from the person causing it. So, that's it for rescissible contracts.